संसद की कार्यवाही शुरू हो चुकी है। दोनों सदनों में बजट पर चर्चा होगी। कांग्रेस से कुमारी शैलजा करेगी चर्चा की शुरुआत। लोकसभा में 20 घंटे का समय निर्धारित किया गया।
मंगुटा सिंगल अन्य सदस्यगणों, मैं आपसे पुनः आग्रह करता हूं, प्रश्नकाल के अंदर किसी भी विषय को किधर भी ना इधर ना उधर विषय को नहीं बोलने देगा। प्रश्नकाल मतलब प्रश्नकाल। आप अगर व्यवस्था बना के रखना चाहते हैं, सदन चलाना चाहते हैं, तो सदन इस व्यवस्था से चलेगा। प्रश्नकाल में किसी को भी अलाउ नहीं किया जाएगा। प्रश्नकाल एक महत्वपूर्ण समय होता है और वह मेंबर्स का समय होता है, इसलिए आप ये व्यवस्थाएं हमेशा परंपरा में रही है और आगे इस परंपरा को और ठीक से लागू किया जाएगा।
सर, 21 सर,
मंत्री महोदय,
जवाब पटल पर रख दिया गया है।
सारे सदस्य,
थैंक यू वेरी मच स्पीकर साहब फॉर गिविंग एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर मी टू स्पीक फर्स्ट टाइम इन दिस 18th लोकसभा। सर, सर, आई एम वेरी मच थैंकफुल टू माय लीडर ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश श्री नारा चंद्रबाबु नायडु गारु फॉर ब्रिंगिंग दिस इश्यू ऑफ डिक्लेरिंग प्रकाश डिस्ट्रिक्ट एज ए बैकवर्ड डिस्ट्रिक्ट। सर, सर, इन द लाइन्स ऑफ यू नो विद द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड विद ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इन द लाइन्स ऑफ बुंदेलखंड। सर, सर, आई हैव बीन फाइटिंग दिस फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम व्हेन आई एंटर्ड इनटू द 12th लोकसभा 26 years back this issue has been raised, sir. Now today I am very happy. Yesterday in the budget itself this has been announced, sir. Prakash, I am very proud to tell to my people of Andhra Pradesh, Prakash, on this day that this the NDA government has done this, you know, favorable for this Andhra Pradesh state, especially by Prakash on this day, sir. Sir, I would like to ask the honorable minister, sir, the funds allocated for this, you know, backward region development is only 50 crores, sir. Whether the honorable minister, sir, to you, sir, this is a small amount after seeing that this has been declared about 25 years back, sir. With now, you know, the population increase and the inflation, whether this 50 crores is going to be increased, sir.
Aspirational Districts Program is a pan-India program. It is a brainchild of the Honorable Prime Minister, and in 2018, all districts were assessed as to find out who were the lowest ranked in living index. 112 districts were selected, and out of those 112 districts, we have tried to make sure that these districts come up at par with the rest of the better off districts in the country. The theme in all these districts to make them rise above their backward race is convergence, cooperation and competition. Convergence of all government schemes, whether they are state government schemes or whether they are Government of India schemes. And then we have made one step forward and ask for cooperation between the state governments and the central governments, and thereafter we had competition amongst all these 112 districts through a delta ranking system, whereby according to the baseline, the performance of each of these districts, how further it has gone up or down, has been decided. Now, Andhra Pradesh had 3 districts which were in the list of 112 aspirational districts. However, 2 of these aspirational districts, namely Visakhapatnam and Vijayanagar, were bifurcated. And instead of Visakhapatnam, Aluri...
आप सदन नहीं चलाना चाहते, प्रश्नकाल नहीं चलाना चाहते, सदन में नियोजित तरीके से गतिरोध करना ठीक नहीं है। और माननीय सदस्यगणों, संसद में प्रदर्शन करते समय इस बात का ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि किसी भी माननीय सदस्य को गेट पे आने पे गतिरोध पैदा नहीं होना चाहिए। मैंने बुलाकर भी चर्चा की है और ये उचित नहीं है, मुझे कई माननीय सदस्यों ने लिखा है।
स्पीकर महोदय, आपने जो अभी रिमार्क किया है, कई मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट ने हमको भी अप्रोच किया है कि ये जो मेन पार्लियामेंट का द्वार है,
मुझे लिख के दिया है, लिख के दिया मुझे,
और आपका संज्ञान में भी आया है, मुझे भी बताया गया है। और दूसरी बात सर, आज क्वेश्चन आवर में जो हमारा ओपोजिशन एमपीस ने जो किया है वो निंदनीय है। ऑल पार्टी मीटिंग में सर, ऑल पार्टी मीटिंग में सारा पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज के फ्लोर लीडर ने कहा हाउस अच्छा से चलना चाहिए, नियम से चलना चाहिए, सब ने कहा, फिर सदन में आकर के इस तरह कैसे डिस्टर्ब करना, क्वेश्चन आवर का डिस्टर्ब करना, ये ठीक नहीं है सर।
सदन में मैं व्यवस्था दे रहा हूँ कि प्रश्नकाल में न प्रतिपक्ष न सत्ता पक्ष की तरफ से किसी को भी बोलने की इजाजत नहीं होगी, केवल प्रश्नकाल में प्रश्नकाल ही चलेगा, ये व्यवस्था है।
सेकंड
सप्लीमेंट्री।
सर थैंक यू वेरी मच स्पीकर सर। सर इन दिस मिनिस्टर्स रिप्लाई स्टेटेड फॉर एस्पेशली आंध्र प्रदेश ओनली 34 crores has been sanctioned, out of that only 49 lakhs only has been spent sir. Well, what is the reason also I would like from the honorable minister, and not only that sir, I requested him also whether this 50 crores is going to be increased later, because 50 crores is a very small amount for a district, for a development sir. And moreover sir, one more thing also, whether this the Prakasam district declared by honorable prime minister with the at the instance of my leader honorable CM Chandrababu Naidu garu, that when will it start also operationally, whether they are going to take it up with the existing aspirational districts sir, list also.
Sir, I was trying to make the honorable member understand that aspirational districts are not given funds from out of the government devolving funds. They are given a delta ranking by virtue of which there is competition amongst all the 112 aspirational districts. The first district amongst those 112 per month gets 10 crore rupees. The district that comes second gets 5 crore rupees. Apart from that, there are sectors like health and nutrition and agriculture and water harvesting which are also assessed. And whoever comes first out of those 112 districts in these parameters is given 3 crores each. So there is no separate budget as such for aspirational districts. All schemes of the central government, all schemes of the state government, they are converged. There is then thereafter there is competition as to which is the best district. So all told, since its inception in 2018, 1582 crores was given for aspirational districts program, which is devolved to the districts by virtue of delta ranking system. After this, in first phase, which was from 2019 to 22, it was 974 crores, and the second phase, which is from 22 to 24, is for 933 crores, which is still in progress. Now there seems to be a little bit of confusion in the honorable member's mind, and he is saying that whether we give funds, it is not us who give funds. The funds have been devolved by the finance ministry, as presented by the honorable Sita Raman, the finance minister. They have given a sizable package to Andhra Pradesh, and right now there is no extra money that can be given through Niti Aayog to these aspirational districts. It has to be a convergence of all schemes that already in force, whether in the state level or in the central level.
Sri माननीय सदस्य श्री रुद्र नारायण पाजी पानी।
सर मैं उड़ीसा से आता हूँ, रुद्र नारायण पानी। धन्यवाद सर, प्रधानमंत्री जी के प्रति जगन्नाथ महाप्रभु,
इसको पानी करना भैया,
पानी PANY पीने का पानी सर। प्रधानमंत्री जी के प्रति जगन्नाथ महाप्रभु का असीम कृपा इस बार हुआ, संयोग से मैं एक आकांक्षी जिला से आता हूं, दैट इज ढेंकनाल। इट इज लोकेटेड इन सेंट्रल ओडिशा। सर, हर जिले में एक एक मेडिकल कॉलेज प्रतिष्ठा स्थापना किया जाएगा, ऐसा पिछले 10 साल में कहा गया है और आशा और विश्वास है कि इस आकांक्षी योजना के अंतर्गत ढेंकनाल जिला में एक, क्या माननीय मंत्री जी का ये विचार है कि इस योजना के अंदर या किसी दूसरे तीसरे योजना के अंदर ढेंकनाल जिला में मेडिकल कॉलेज और हॉस्पिटल क्या बनाया जाएगा?
जनाब स्पीकर साहब, ओडिशा के अंदर कुल मिलाकर के एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स 10 हैं, जिनमें कुल मिलाकर के जो प्रोजेक्ट्स सैंक्शन हुए हैं वो 104 हुए हैं और जो सैंक्शनड अमाउंट है वो 126 करोड़ है। ये जो मंत्री जी मेरे से पूछ रहे हैं, शायद बेहतर होता मेडिकल कॉलेज के विषय के अंदर अगर हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री से चर्चा करी होती तो वही इस बात के अंदर जवाब देने में ज़्यादा सक्षम होंगे, मैं समझता हूँ।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 22, डॉक्टर नामदेव किसान।
सर, इट इज दैट, थैंक यू सर फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी।
आप पहले प्रश्न नंबर बोल दें।
ब्रॉडगेज रेलवे लाइन का ये स्कीम है फ्रॉम वर्षा टू गढ़चिरौली। आई बिलोंग टू गढ़चिरौली चिमूर लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी विच इज टू बैकवर्ड एंड इट इज ट्राइबल डिस्ट्रिक्ट। So this railway line started in 2022 and still the work is going very slowly and it is not getting completed. And another broad gauge railway line is from Nagpur to Nagbhid, that is also the work is going.
Sabke thali khali aur do ke thali mein pakoda aur ye apna jilobi.
Ek second.
ये दो छोड़ के किसी को नहीं मिला कुछ, ना करना, ना तमिलनाडु को मिला, ना केरला को मिला, ना कर्नाटक को मिला, ना महाराष्ट्र को मिला, ना ये पंजाब, ना हरियाणा, ना राजस्थान, ना छत्तीसगढ़, ना किसी स्टेट को कुछ नहीं, दिल्ली को नहीं दिया, तो मैं कितने गिनूं? ओडिशा को कुछ नहीं दिया, तो ऐसा बजट मैं कभी नहीं देखा। और ये सिर्फ किसी को खुश करने के लिए, खुर्ची बचाने के लिए वो ये सब हुआ है, इसका हम कंडम करते हैं। और इस ढंग से बजट पेश अगर हो गया, मैं समझता हूँ वो कर्नाटक से आए हैं। नहीं, कर्नाटक से आए हैं सर, हमारी तो अपेक्षा ऐसी थी सबसे ज्यादा मुझे ही मिलेगा, लेकिन वो इतना हमको तो कुछ नहीं मिला, तो इसका तो हम कंडम करेंगे, प्रोटेस्ट करेंगे और सारे इंडिया पार्टी अलायंस, सारे कन्याकुमारी से लेकर कश्मीर तक।
नहीं,
मैं बोल देता हूँ, उन्होंने तो बोलने में, सो माता जी बोलने में तो एक्सपर्ट है, मुझे मालूम है, तो उसी
तो माता जी नहीं, आपकी बेटी के बराबर हैं।
मैं अपनी
तो
बात
रख रहा हूं,
तो इसीलिए सर मैं कंडम करता हूं। अगर आप जिस जगह अपोजिशन पार्टी चुन के आ गई, जिस जगह आपको निग्लेक्ट किया गया है या लोगों ने नकार दिया आपको, उस जगह कुछ नहीं मिला। और लोग अगर ऐसा आप करते गए, अगर बैलेंस नहीं होगा, डेवलपमेंट कैसा होगा? आज आपके साथ है, कल लोग वो दूसरों के साथ हो गए,
तो लोग अलग-अलग
समय में अलग अलग से करते हैं, इसीलिए मैं इसका कंडम करता हूँ। हम सभी पार्टी के लोग इसको कंडम करते हैं, इस टाइप के एटीट्यूड के लिए।
Sir,
Honorable Finance Minister.
Sir, thank you for giving me an opportunity to respond. Much before I respond, they would like to make a lot of noise and go away. In the true spirit of democracy, they don't even want. Sir, it's a.
Will go on record. Honorable members, please. Honorable members, discussion on the budget was listed today. And I gave floor to the leader of the opposition in expectation that rules will be followed. I find it has been used as a ploy and a strategy. Honorable members, I strongly plead with you. Democracy will be seriously threatened if disruption and disturbance are weaponized as a political strategy, as has been done now. Parliament is citadel of constitutional and democratic values and liberties. I am aghast, as a matter of fact, when during the day and days following, we'll have ample opportunity to reflect on the budget presented by the Honorable Finance Minister. There was absolutely no occasion, justification, even remotely, to avail the facility accorded by me for this purpose. I cannot persuade myself but to take serious exception to this unwholesome practice adopted by a senior member, leader of the opposition. I will call upon leaders of the parties to soul search, and my reflections about Rule 267, that in more than three decades it has been availed only for half a dozen occasions. And every day of the sitting, I get number of such requests. It is being taken as a routine exercise, as a habit. It has reduced itself to a farcical exercise. In spite of my serious observations yesterday, since no focus has taken place, I have again uploaded the same on your portal, Honorable Finance Minister, to the observations made.
So thank you very much for giving this opportunity, although it is unfortunate that the opposition, particularly a senior leader, leader of the opposition, Sri Mallikarjun Kharge, who stood up to say his views on what he heard of the budget yesterday. I would think, and maybe it's a bit too much to expect, that in the honor of democracy, at least the opposition would have stayed here to listen to what I have to respond now that the leader of the opposition raised issues on the budget which was presented yesterday and tabled in this house yesterday. Just to the point that he raised, that I have not named many states and probably spoke about only two states. There are a few points which I have to table here with your permission, voice here with your permission, as to what happens in a speech. Congress party has been in power for a very long time in this country. They presented so many different budgets, and they would know clearly that in every budget, You don't get an opportunity to name every state of this country. I'll take this example. Between vote-on account, which was presented on 1st February this year, and now the full budget, which was presented yesterday for this year, I have not named very many states. But let me take the example of Maharashtra, for instance. Between vote-on account and yesterday's budget, in vote-on account and in yesterday's budget, I had not named Maharashtra. I'll take it as an example. Cabinet has, under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi, passed a very important decision. It has taken the decision to set up a very big port in Vadhavan in Maharashtra. Did Maharashtra get ignored because I did not mention the name of Maharashtra? 76,000 crores have been announced for that project. Maharashtra's name was not taken in the vote on account, nor was it taken yesterday. But does it mean that we've ignored Maharashtra? And I can take the name of so many other different states where we have major projects, one. And second, if the speech does not mention the name of a particular state, does it mean that the schemes of the Government of India, the programs of Government of India, the externally aided assistance which we obtain from the World Bank and ADB and AIB and so on, institutions such as that, don't go to these states? They go as per a routine. And actually the expenditure statement of the government, the department-wise allocation of the government, clearly item-wise mentions all this. This is a deliberate attempt, and I'm saying this with responsibility. This is a deliberate attempt of the opposition parties led by the Congress party to give an impression to the people, oh, nothing has been given to our states, it's only been given to two states. I would challenge the Congress party for all the budget speeches that they've delivered, that in each of the budget speeches, have they named every state of this country? This is an outrageous allegation. This is an outrageous allegation. And now that they have come here, now that the TMC has come here, I would like to say, now that there's a member trying to disrupt me, I would like to say, sir, even the schemes which have been given to Bengal.
Thank you.
Even the schemes, Chairman, sir, you should allow me to say this. Even the schemes which
nothing
have been allocated
recorded,
to
no
Bengal.
Show. Mr. Saket,
sir,
don't
you
lie.
Asked me to speak.
No, please don't shout. Don't
you
shout,
have
don't
asked
shout.
Me to speak.
This is not a shouting place. Is it a shouting place? Dr. John Bittas, Priyanka Chaturvedi, even senior member Dona Sen. No. Please, no. Take your seat.
Sir, let me just finish, sir. I hope I'll.
Honorable members, one second. Take your seat. Take your seat. Please take your seat. Take your seat. Honorable members, please take your seat. One second. Honorable members.
Complete, sir.
Okay, finish. Finished. 2 minutes.
Sir.
2 minutes.
Yes, I will speak on Bengal. I've already spoken on Maharashtra for the members who chose to walk out of the house without you listening to my reply. Sir, let me have some order, sir, in the house.
Honorable Finance
sir,
Minister,
let me tell you, sir,
you have ample opportunity to respond to each
yes,
of them.
Yes, sir, but this
when
kind
you
of a statement
respond.
By a very senior member of the house, leader of the opposition, it's I think, not acceptable. And let me answer, sir, the members from the TMC. Even yesterday, the TMC questioned the budget, saying, oh, nothing has been given to Bengal. Let me just highlight the fact that the several schemes given by Honorable Prime Minister in the last 10 years have not even been implemented in West Bengal. Health insurance. And you have the audacity to ask me now?
Okay, sir.
Bengal should correct its
Honorable members, matter. कमीशन श्रीमती मौसम नूर Mr. Patel, please, all of you, take your seat. Mr. Patel, take your seat. Jairam, take your seat. Sir, you created chaos. Once the honorable members, one second. Please allow me to speak. Please. One second. All of you take your seat. Please, honorable members.